How strong is a Komodo dragon compared to other reptiles? In many movies, you'll see the most feared reptile is either represented as a crocodile or some massive snake. But maybe these animals need to step aside. A different animal may be trying to claim the title of King of the Reptiles. It's well known enough, the Komodo dragon. But how much do you know about the Komodo dragon? Do you know about its size and its strength? And how does its strength compare to that of other reptiles? Can the Komodo dragon really stake its claim as the king of all reptiles on planet Earth? Komodo dragons. It's time we meet the Komodo dragon up close and personal. We'll get up close and personal, you keep your distance. They aren't friendly. For those of you terrified by their appearance, you're in luck. They aren't found in many places in the world. Komodo dragons are strictly found in specific islands of Indonesia, in Komodo, where they obtained their name, and also Rinca, Flores, and Gili Mutang. Komodo dragons are the largest lizards on the planet. An adult male will be about 8.5 feet long on average and will weigh between 150 to 170 pounds. However, there have been plenty of Komodo dragons found in the wild that have been 10 feet long and clock in at around 200 pounds. Even at their minimum sizes, they are gigantic and terrifying. They are bigger than humans and weigh around the same, sometimes weighing more. Because of their size, they are not only apex predators on the islands that they live on, they absolutely dominate those islands. Perhaps that even contributes to their size, because no other predator comes close to their size. This isn't like some habitats where there are multiple predators and they all contend with one another. The apex predator may not be so clear-cut, or it's a close call. Everyone on these islands knows it is the Komodo dragon. It's like inserting a T-Rex into a petting zoo. You'll have a lot of unhappy customers, but you will know who the top dog is. Komodo dragons have about 60 teeth that are all serrated, and they can be up to an inch long each. You can imagine those wouldn't feel too good if a Komodo dragon bit into you, not to mention their bite force, which is recorded between 500 to 600 psi. Now, that bite force is nothing to sneeze at, but it isn't the most powerful bite in the animal kingdom. Yes, it will do some damage, but Komodo dragons rely on some other things when it comes to causing harm. For one, the bite force is what it is, but many of their teeth are curved, which delivers devastating injuries when sunk into their prey or any opponent. Additionally, they have venom glands in their lower jaw, so when they bite, they will often inject that venom into the victim. The venom also prevents the blood from clotting, so it's also not allowing the wound to heal. And as if the bite of a Komodo dragon didn't seem horrible enough, they also have long, sturdy claws. Komodo dragons are quite dependent on using their claws for slashing at prey with their dexterous limbs. The claws will usually measure at 1¾ inches, so almost twice as long as their teeth. Usually a Komodo dragon will attack its prey, whatever it may be. It will deliver some slashes, probably a bite or two, and then oftentimes the prey will escape, but not for long. Because the common occurrence is that the Komodo dragon just needs to deliver a few blows, and then it waits for the prey to inevitably die from the injuries, to which the Komodo dragon can then roll up onto the carcass and consume what it wants. This method has proven effective. The Komodo dragon is extremely powerful, and its hunting methods are fantastic. It can take down huge animals, and they can get aggressive. If they perceive a threat, they will initiate an attack. You may be wondering if Komodo dragon attacks on humans have ever occurred. Oh, they have happened. Komodo dragons have attacked a number of humans over the years, and it never goes well for the human. But how would the Komodo dragon stack up against other reptiles? Python. Let's take a look at one massive snake. We're going to take a look at a python, but not just any python, the reticulated python. The reticulated python is the world's longest python, also the world's longest snake, and it's even the third heaviest snake. They're often just short of 20 feet long, and there have even been some to reach lengths of over 21 feet. They also can weigh up to 165 pounds. They typically go for small mammals and birds, but larger reticulated pythons have been known to go for pigs, deer. One instance, a python consumed a small sun bear, and they've been known to prey on and eat humans. The reticulated python will ambush its prey, wrap around it, and constrict it until it kills it. The smaller ones can apply 10 pounds of pressure per square inch, and the largest can apply up to 50 pounds of pressure per square inch. This is obviously a terribly slow and awful death for the prey, and though the reticulated python is massive, could it really constrict a Komodo dragon? The dragon also has its own amazing self-defense mechanisms: its bite, its teeth, its claws, and its own sheer power. All the Komodo dragon needs to do is land one slash, one bite, and then he'd just wait. And the Komodo dragon will still outweigh the python in almost every instance. Alligator. Let's talk about a reptile that is definitely larger than the Komodo dragon, the alligator. We'll look at the American alligator, which averages 13 feet long and weighs 790 pounds. They've got a few feet in length on the Komodo dragon and several hundred pounds. And remember when we talked about the Komodo dragon's bite force being between 500 to 600 psi? We also hinted at that being somewhat weak in the animal kingdom, especially compared to their reptile enemy, the American alligator, who has a bite force of 2,000 psi or more. Yes, the American alligator is superior in size, weight, and bite strength, but here's an interesting tidbit about the Komodo dragon: their extremely tough skin. Komodo dragons have skin that is reinforced by armored scales. The scales have tiny bones called osteoderms. These osteoderms are kind of like a chainmail that a knight would wear. Now, alligators have them too, as do many reptiles. Now, most lizards have one or two varying patterns of osteoderms. Komodo dragons have four, making their hide rugged. So they are equipped with a natural defense system, and as long as the Komodo doesn't get in the water with the alligator, he could be okay. A Komodo dragon is far more agile on land than an alligator is. A Komodo is equipped to dash around on land. An alligator cannot turn around nearly as fast as a Komodo dragon could get behind him, slash and bite and wait. The Komodo may lack in power compared to the alligator, but he wouldn't necessarily lack in fighting style. King Cobra. Let's take a look at another enormous snake. In fact, this one holds the title of the world's largest venomous snake. That would be the King Cobra. The King Cobra can be found in Asia and can reach between 10 and 13 feet long. Of all the venomous snakes, they're not the most venomous, but their poisonous bite still packs a punch. It is said that 50 to 60% of King Cobra bites on humans are fatal if left untreated. No one wants to leave a bite to the fate of a coin flip. That's still serious stuff. However, these snakes usually just weigh around 20 pounds. They rely heavily on their bite, which could even bring down an elephant. He and the Komodo dragon have that in common, but let's not forget the Komodo's size advantage and his armor-like skin. The King Cobra's teeth may not even penetrate his hide if he even gets a bite on him. A King Cobra would be more agile than the alligator we spoke of before, but a Komodo dragon could still use its agility and power to get behind the snake, pin it down, and have his way with it. A King Cobra would be no match for a Komodo. Alligator Snapping Turtle. We compared the Komodo dragon to an alligator. Now, how about an alligator snapping turtle? The alligator snapping turtle is the largest freshwater turtle in the world. They can get to be 32 inches long and weigh a whopping 170 pounds. Right around the same weight as the Komodo dragon, though not as long. And besides it being a humongous turtle, it is a snapping turtle. That means the bite is strong and fast. Their bite force is 1,000 psi, basically twice as strong as the Komodo, and they can bite at speeds of 200 miles per hour. And their neck can extend out two-thirds the length of their shell. That means if it decides to bite you and you are within its range, it's going to get you. No one is escaping that speed. But we know the turtle itself to not be too fast, and though it weighs similarly to the Komodo, it isn't nearly as long. The Komodo possesses far greater strength in its body and forelimbs. The bite of the snapping turtle is far worse, so our Komodo would need to watch himself around the front of this creature. But all he needs to do is get to a vulnerable spot of the turtle, and it's game over. Anaconda. We saw the longest snake in the world, the reticulated python. Now let's meet the second longest snake in the world, which is also the largest and heaviest snake in the world, the green anaconda. Green anacondas are found largely in South America and are semi-aquatic. They can get up to 17 feet long and weigh 170 pounds. Another reptile rivaling the weight of the Komodo and is technically longer, much longer. The green anaconda is not venomous, it is a constrictor. They'll use their jaws to bite and trap their prey, and then wrap around them and constrict them, suffocating them. Their bite force is actually quite strong, 900 psi. Their squeeze is said to be around 90 psi, similar to that of an elephant stepping on you. That is powerful, and if a green anaconda managed to wrap itself around a Komodo dragon, who knows if the Komodo could get out? Then again, what do we always say about the Komodo? Just let him get one slash, one bite, and then he will wait. Even if the anaconda thinks it can power through a wound from a Komodo and still constrict, eventually that wound is going to do its damage, and the venom and infection will do its trick. Not to mention the power and agility of the Komodo, he may never get himself in that bad position in the first place. Crocodile. Finally, let's look at the world's largest reptile, the saltwater crocodile. These nasty guys can reach 21 feet long and weigh over 2,000 pounds. All crocodiles are much bigger than the Komodo, but this guy is about 11 times the weight. And that's not even the scariest part about the saltwater crocodile. It is that bite. One of the strongest bites in the world, with a force of 3,700 psi. Now, this would be a tough battle for the Komodo dragon. He is vastly undersized, and that bite of the crocodile is scary. The crocodile can ambush and move fast, especially in water. On land, he may have a chance. He is much smaller than the crocodile, but we know him to be more agile on land. The saltwater crocodile is such a massive beast, he overpowers the Komodo dragon, but he cannot keep up with him. The Komodo would have a slight chance. Let him get a bite or two, a slash or two, and anything can happen. But he better retreat after getting a few hits in, because that crocodile could destroy him in an instant. Luckily for the Komodo dragon, they don't come across any crocodiles on their islands, so they're safe for now.